Hello YouTube. It's been a while, hasn't it? Yeah, I mean, I think my last video, or last post on YouTube was just before Christmas. And I did say I was going to be back in February, but I took a wee bit more time, which everybody does, you know what I mean? So I just thought it was about time for me to come back on YouTube, show my face to the people that follow me, people that like my videos, and I also wanted to elaborate briefly on a couple of posts that I've put up on Instagram recently. So, the two posts or recent posts that I've put up, I mean, obviously I mentioned people know it was my birthday recently, and I used that time to reflect on what the last year was. Eh? So, the last year for me was all about hardship and growing from hardship and setbacks, stuff like that. But I chose, or when I was thinking about it at the weekend, it was important for me to reflect on any positive that came. So any positive that I thought had come from the last year. So I did do that, and I sort of elaborated on the fact that yes, it's definitely okay for anybody to not be okay. But what I actually discussed it with my wife, and we both agreed that a really good thing to elaborate on that would be when you are accepting the fact that you're not okay is one thing, and staying there is an absolute other. But what I will say is, there's steps that these things can be seen as steps. So, firstly, what I would say is acknowledging that you are not okay is a huge step. I mentioned that in post. Celebrate that as the biggest step forward, and it is a huge step forward. For a while, I would wallow, or for years, I would wallow in the silly thinking of I don't have anxiety, I can't have depression, it's me. Or if I felt that, it was like, well, I can't really show people that because that's people would think I'm weak. I don't want people to think that I've got something wrong with me. But that's just an absolute ridiculous mindset, and it gets you nowhere. So coming over that, getting over that hurdle, firstly, of not, or being okay with not being okay, is just a huge thing. But what I'm trying to say is being okay, or accepting that you're not okay, sorry, is the first step, but don't stay there. Yeah? What I mean by that is, that's one big step, so take the next big step to figure out what you want to be. Who are you? Who is it you want to become? Where do you want to go? What do you want to change? That sort of thing. And these are really, really big questions. And often, more often than not, you don't actually have the answer. I don't have all the answers for my mind just now. I've taken the step to accept the fact that I am going to struggle with a lot of stuff. I am going to have a lot of setbacks. I am going to have hardness in my life, but it's not always going to stay. I'm not going to stay in the one spot. I actually didn't mention this in my story, but a huge thing for me over the last year was taking a bit of a risk, taking some risks, making big goals. And that comes from what I've got from my PT, Kenny. He was go big with your goals, and that's what I've done. I mean, it was seen that when last year I did a, run about this time last year, I did a strongman competition, totally out of my comfort zone, did it just for the sake of it, turned up, kept saying to my wife, if I get in the top three, I'll be fine, I'm happy with that, I'm not going to win. And let's be honest, I was there to fucking win, no doubt about it. I was going there to show how strong I am, where I've become, what I have become, and how far I've came. And I won it, and I'm not ashamed to say that I won it quite comfortably, and I'm not ashamed to say that I was very good. Surprised myself, PB'd every single one of my lifts, and it was the best feeling in the world. And it was a feeling that pushed me the next day to think, actually, let's go bigger. Let's aim even bigger. That, I think, the following, or either the next check-in I had with my coach, or the two check-ins later, I told him I want to go on stage. And he said, let's put a pin in that. We're not saying no, but put a pin in it. That's our goal. That's the goal that we're going for. And now, we're at the point now where that's becoming reality. It's not for this year, but next year. But there's steps that we're taking this year, i.e. I'm about to step into, there's a wee spider there, sorry. I'm about to step in next week to a photo shoot prep. Another thing that's a huge thing out of my comfort zone. A photo shoot? Madness. But I want to do it. It's a huge thing. I got it as a Christmas present from my wife. She has been the biggest encouragement I've had, and she's acknowledging what my goals are and saying, this is a step for you, let's do it. Acknowledged by my coach again, and that's what we're stepping into next week, to get my body into the best physical shape it has ever been, as in never been seen before shape for me. And am I nervous? Absolutely. Am I shiting it? Abso-fucking-lutely. But my coach believes in me, my wife believes in me, and my family believe in me. So I believe in myself. And that's a big step for me, and I think that is my next step, believe in yourself. That's my step. I've learned that, I've explored that, and I've seen what other people see in me. And that's the step that I'm taking. So basically, what I'm trying to get is when you've accepted the fact that you're not okay, accept that, yes, then look to see what your next step is. What is my next goal? My next goal, like I mentioned there, is the photo shoot, then the goal after that would be stage. So what's your goal? Is your goal just to get a job? Is your goal to get back into fitness? Is your job to rekindle any relationships? Is your goal to be more social? Anything at all, no step or no decision is too small. So make those big decisions, make those steps, and be happy. I mean, everybody sees themselves differently than to what other people see you. What people see in me, sometimes I don't believe, and that's okay. It's what you are willing to believe in that you, or believe that you can achieve. I believe I can achieve these goals that I've set out, and as far as I'm concerned, I'm going to get them, and I'm going to achieve them. So that was just a wee quick follow-up on my recent posts on Instagram. If you haven't seen them, please go on and have a look at them. Give them a like, give them a share. Share them around the place, because I want that sort of message to be seen. It's probably all over Instagram, I've no doubt about it. But people who are in my sort of network, I want them to see that it is not okay to be okay. Sorry, it is okay to not be okay. Sorry, don't get that mixed up. But in my opinion, and this is just purely my opinion, it is not okay to stay there. Does that make sense? I hope it makes sense. I'm not going to wallow on or waffle on any more. What I'm going to put on at the end of this now is just a wee workout that I did on my legs through the week, just to get me back and get people back into swing and see what my workouts and what my sessions look like just now. I'm pretty confident they may change over the next couple of weeks because my food's going to change, my plans are going to change into a cut. But this is basically the ending of my improvement phase, and next you'll see what a leg workout looks for me. All right, hope you enjoyed that. I will put a couple of things up. I'll share this on Instagram for people to see. Please do like it, please do share it, please do respect my message if you want. And if you've got any comments or any messages that you want to ask me or me to elaborate on anything, please get in touch. I'm probably more approachable outside the gym than I am in the gym. People won't know that. But anyway, I've definitely waffled on longer than I should have. So I hope you enjoy the leg workout, and I'll speak to you next time on the tubes. But you will remember me. Remember me for centuries. Just one mistake is all it will take. We'll go down in history. Remember me for centuries.
said, her from the city, so her got to be witty, witty. She said, him from the country, so him got to be funky, funky.
Hey,